Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we're going to focus on Murda Beats. Murda Beats is an influential figure in the producer community, and a lot of people look up to him. Shout out Murda Beats. Today we're going to focus on his style, and if you study from Smoke Perp and Murda Beats, you'll hear the kind of consistency between the tracks. And that's what I mean by a style. Just like Ronnie J can jump from style to style, so can Murda Beats. Murda Beats is focused, you know, mainstream-wise on like the trap sound. So let's start with that in mind. It's a trap sound. We're going to keep a very minimalistic approach. And we're going to use a lot of trap melody technology. So let's get started. Now first, I think I'm going to start with the drum rhythm instead of the melody in the chords, because mainly I haven't found too many chords in his tracks. Okay, so let's go to BusyWorksBeats.com and let's go to the Ultimate Producer Bundle, which also has FL Studio project templates in here as well. And let's find an 808. Let's turn the tempo up. So 140 is a good place to start, 144, somewhere around there. Here's a good 808, 808 distortion. Let's just make sure we find the key. Go to your pitch tab, detect, okay, it's middle C, so it's all correctly at C. Now we need to find a kick. Now I'll show you the main thing that like I learned from him, which is the boom, 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 which is a little bouncy bongo. And the sample is very similar to the sample in the X drums, which is now in the Ultimate Producer Bundle. So let me show you what I mean. So one, two, three, boom, 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 boom. So let me add it in. One, two, three, boom, boom, two, three, boom. Just that little bounce at the end of the drums. So let me find one, two, three, four, five, six, two, three, four. Okay, so let's add it in. So I'm gonna start with the 808 rhythm. We're not trying to go crazy with the 808 tone just yet. I'm thinking of the 808 like a kick drum. I got my timing way off. One, two, 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 boom, boom, boom. So I'm gonna move the bongo bounce over. Okay, so the bongo bounce at the tail end is what I've learned, is to delay it a little bit. I had mine usually early. Is that a clap in here? So the clap goes on the 3 and the 7. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You can add variation with kicks. You don't need a kick, but to add a little more punch, we're gonna add a kick. So I've noticed there's no like third kick, like a dance rhythm. Boom, boom, boom. It's like boom, 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 boom. Let's delay it a little bit with the time, with the wrench tool time shift. So it's a little bit delayed. We'll kind of do that in context. You have to really get your groove going. Let's add a hi-hat. Now here is a style that it's okay to stop. Usually I never stop my hi-hats, I keep them going. Okay, so when I add a rest, I'm gonna do a glitch near after, so it kind of compensates. So boom, boom. right here where we have that big rest, or like right here. I'm gonna compensate with the hi-hat roll. Let's drag it out, hit Alt A, and then change your time multiplier. I learned that from a Chop Squad DJ. Just get rid of some of the extra hi-hats. Create your own rhythm. I'm just showing you. Now, usually people just stop at like one hi-hat rhythm. Probably should create at least two. So I'm going to leave the dip, dip, dip for the next bar. Delay the hi-hats a little bit. So now we have a rhythm. Let's add some melody stuff on top. If you listen to a lot of the tracks, again, on that Bless Your Trap project, it's just very minimalistic. It's like two note melodies, sometimes it's three note melodies, so it changes. So let's go to Nexus. Let's search flute. I think I have so many searches, I need to delete these. There's so many of them. Might as well do it right now. Okay, make sure you don't delete a folder. I don't know why it saves every search. That's kind of outrageous, but anyway, we're gonna search flute, right click, do new search, flute. And let's see what matches this vibe. Now the 808, I'm gonna change the tuner. Adding a little attack so it's not so harsh. That. Alright, now you can add halftime. It might be a little OD here because it's not much movement in the flute, but let's add halftime. Yes, this is not. Halftime in the original melody, you can turn it to just one. See how it just sounds repetitive? Let's pick a different sound. That's pretty cool. That one's actually pretty dope. Sounds video game-esque, but sounds cool. I'm gonna take out a lot of the bass. So we didn't mix the track yet. I'm just getting the core concept down. Let me change the tuning of the 808, pump the drums a little harder. I'm just trying to get a tone so we can run it through different melody effects like glitch too. Let's get some of those weird glitches out of here, but it sounds like this is the one I like. I think it's the modulator making it sound like that. That one just has a lot going on. So I'm just gonna go through presets until I find something that has a vibe. If I don't find a vibe, I'm gonna make my own. Only thing about this plugin is that it's directly on the grid with the effects. There's no way to delay the plugin effect unless you automate it. So it's like super to the grid, but everything else is off the grid. So let me group the drums. Mix the drums a bit. Thank you. see how much goes into trap melodies. It's a lot more than just what you play. Also, I have a theory that he adds delay before his gross beat effects. I haven't really studied it, but I believe so. Maybe a slight delay, just so it kind of stretches the sound out a bit more before it goes through halftime. So now I'm gonna mix the drums harder. I might do, which is another technique, instead of using an 808, what I'm going to do is merge pattern 1 and 2 so we can have the MIDI information. So we'll go to here, go to edit, merge pattern clips. It's going to make this one big MIDI thing, and we're going to hit on the 808, hit control C, right click, find first empty. We're going to open up a new synth, not a new synth, but Silenth 1. Where is it at? Silenth 1. Here we go. And program our own bass line underneath the kick. So it's going to sound like an 808, but it's really not. So let's clear. How do we? I forget how to start this thing over. Clear. Yeah, there we go. And so now instead of an 808, we're going to use a bass tone, and we're going to give it a note length. It's very important to give it a note length so it feels like an 808, but it's really not, or else it will ring on forever without ending. So I'm going to experiment with triangle waves and sawtooth underlayers and different things. You'll see. See how it sounds cleaner than an 808? So just a triangle wave. And if you're going to do it this way, make sure you're kicking your 808 lineup. So I changed the way I produced the drums. Dirty the 808 up a little bit more. I mean the sub bass. So you want to create a B section. I'll probably use halftime to do it, and I'm going to mix the master a little bit, not go ham on it, but just to give it a bigger stage. So hopefully you saw the little tricks with the 808s and the melody. I'll play it twice through, then we'll wrap it up. Bless your trap. If you want to learn more, subscribe today. And please like the video and share with your friends so that we can help more producers around the world and artists around the world. It's BusyWorksBeats.com.